I am a visionary. I am a revolutionary. I am your world heavyweight champion. I am Seth. Still a pretty big pop, I'd say. In Vegas, we are on the road to WrestleMania, WrestleMania 40, WrestleMania XL, extra large, the biggest WrestleMania of all time. Now, what do you say? We cut to the chase and we get ourselves a main event. Now, I'm not the man to make that decision. I'm just a prize at the end of the road. So what do you say we get the man who can make that decision out here? The two-time Royal Rumble winner, the American Nightmare himself, Cody Rhodes.
Acknowledge me.
Hey guys, he showed up for work once. I love to see it. Good to see you, big brother.
And he showed up to work in his wife's shoes.
Anyway, don't be mad, don't be mad. I can just run circles around you.
Let's talk about somebody who matters right now. Let's talk about Cody Rhodes. The man who can't make his own choice, huh? Mr. Hesitation. Here's a life lesson, kids. If you hesitate, your moment's gonna move on. And that's what's happened to Cody Rhodes. It's no longer his decision. It's now your tribal chief's decision. That's exactly how it works, thank you. So tonight, I choose who faces me in the main event of WrestleMania. Get this bum out of here, will you? Just get this bum out of here already, huh? I choose. I choose The Rock. Finally, The Rock has come back to Las Vegas. Now let The Rock ask you a question. Do you think that Roman Reigns is going to beat The Rock at WrestleMania? You think that The Rock is gonna beat the Tribal Chief at WrestleMania?
Oh! think that The Rock and Roman Reigns will be the biggest main event in the history of the WWE? All right. I love the passion. The Rock loves the passion. So, to members of the press, welcome. Glad you're here. To the WWE Universe. To the WWE Universe, welcome. To everyone watching around the world, welcome. And certainly, to the millions of The Rock's fans, welcome. And on top of all that, members of the press, world watching, I introduce you to the Cody Crybabies. Let The Rock show you all and everyone around the world. I'm gonna show you something right now that is very important. It's very cool. And I think you're gonna like it a lot. But regardless whether you like it or you don't like it, you love it, you hate it, one thing for damn sure, you are gonna respect it. Take a look.
Go Rollins! Get him, Seth! Get him, Seth!
When you look at this incredible family tree. And I want you to take a look at the very top of the tree. At the top of that tree, The Rock's grandfather and Roman's grandfather made a blood oath in that our family in Samoan said, Ainga, Ainga forever. And if you can't see that, if you can't see the fact that this is proof that there is only one dominant and powerful royal family in professional wrestling, if you can't see that, and if you think that The Rock and Roman Reigns isn't the biggest main event in the history of WrestleMania, then save your booze, save your booze. Then, if that's what you think, then in simple rock speak, it doesn't matter what you think. WrestleMania 40, Philadelphia, The Rock and Roman Reigns, the Universal Champion versus the People's Champion. Whether you like it or you don't like it, the People's Champion in the biggest main event in the history of professional wrestling, bound by blood.
Hold on, hold on. This right here is Roman, you're out here calling the shots, dictating WrestleMania 40. And as the tribal chief, as the undisputed champion, you have a lot of stroke. But it is not your right, it is not your distinction to determine the main event. It is mine. I won the Royal Rumble. And Rock, we had a wonderful conversation. I had many conversations. I have made my decision. At WrestleMania 40, in the main event, I choose you, Roman Reigns.
Crazy. You must be stupid or something, huh? This is a done deal. You're old news. Go over there with the number twos. The number two table will have you now. Loser bracket. Right there in the dummy in green. Just go. Leave. You're embarrassing yourself now. Last year was your year. That was your moment. You were only a chapter in my book. Nobody cares about your story. Nobody cares about you finishing the story. You're embarrassing your entire family now. You, just understand this, you're irrelevant, just like your dad.
Here you are talking about family. Is that what the bloodline is? Let me ask you a question. How's Jay? It's not a family. You're a meal ticket, and they are nothing but lackeys, but yes men. They're goons. And what is this match all about right here? Who sits at the head of the table? What does it matter when neither of you have been doing any of the cooking for 2 years? Earlier, we had that family tree up there. And you've invoked my father before, so let me go ahead and do the same. If your grandfather was here, if the high chief, his grandfather, was here, they'd be ashamed of you.
Let me make something perfectly clear to you. When you talk about his family, you're talking about my family. When you're talking about his ancestors, you're talking about my ancestors. And when you're talking about his blood, you're talking about my blood. So now, We have a problem.
You don't get to just do whatever you want.
No, you don't.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do.